Hi, I want to demonstrate how you can use mapping and cube ground control with your PixHawk to check if you have xChips connected to your I2C bus. Okay, so here we have the PixHawk, here we have the PD01, this is the interface between our xChips and the PixHawk, and here we have a CO2 sensor, it's the ST33. So if you want to connect these together, this is one way of doing it. We have not done a library for the ST33, we haven't done a library for almost any of the chips, but if you want to do a library and you just want to get over the hardware connectivity, here's the way to do the hardware. But you want to check that it's not a waste of your time. So how do we check if this is working? So you have this screen here. Normally, if you go to the last tab here and you go down to Mapping Console, you get a console here. And there's a number of different commands. I'm not going to go into details, but one of them is you can go in and say RGB LED status. And it says it's red. And you can see it is red. This is the RGB LED anyhow. If you stop it, RGB LED stop, it stops flashing. Might still be on otherwise, but it stops flashing. So we're gonna use this thing here, because if I say RGB LED status, you will see here that it says not started. And you can see here it says I can choose what bus I want to connect it to. Okay, now the bus and the address is you can change that, but if I say RGB LED and I have the address here and it suggests 0x55 because that's indeed where the LED is, and it says start, then you can see it starts flashing again. Okay, and I will write here that it connected with the bus with in 100 kilohertz. So we say RGB LED stop, okay. And then let me now demonstrate that I do it with something that's not connected at all. So we say RGB LED dash address 0x77 and start. Then it comes up and say no RGB LED on bus 2, okay. So that's because nothing responds to that address. If I say do the same thing, but now instead of that, I say 76, sorry, 5, what's the right address? 5A here, and start. It comes up and say, it started. Okay, it found it something on bus 1 for 5A. And you can see nothing is blinking here. That's because it's actually talking to that. How do we know? Well, let me stop it first, okay. Then I take it out, put it here next to it, and then I start it again on the same address. And you can see now it says it's not there. So that is a way to just verify that you actually have I2C connectivity and it responds to that address. So you know that you are talking to that right chip and it's working. Thank you for listening.